गायत्री ने की एंड मैंने टर्न ही लेक्सेस एंड कम एंड वॉच ही लेक्स क्लिक आई हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट ओपीसी रजिस्ट्रेशन दैट इज वन पर्सन कंपनी रजिस्ट्रेशन एंड ऑल्सो टॉक्ड अबाउट इन केस यू वॉन्ट टू क्लोज अ कंपनी वट विल बी द प्रोसीजर हाउ यू कैन क्लोज अ वन पर्सन कंपनी बट इन दिस वीडियो विल डिस्कस अबाउट how to convert a one person company to a private limited company so converting one person company to a private company can open avenues to pursue additional benefits such as fundraising an opc can voluntarily convert into plc that is private limited company without fulfilling the criteria of paid up share capital and average annual turnover The application conversion is made to central government after alteration of MOA and AOA of the COPC. The legal existence of the company continues even after the conversion and so do their rights and liabilities. With its conversion to private company, minimum two shareholders and directors must be appointed to fulfill the minimum requirement of a private limited company. Conversion helps with the growth opportunities along with additional funding options of private placements, funding, ESOP and many more. Now what are the benefits of conversion of one person company to private limited company? In case you want to convert, you must know the benefits of conversion. First, easier to raise funds. When you have a private limited company, then it gets easy to raise funds. Comparatively easy task as it gives an opportunity for raising shares and has many ways to raise funds in the form of private equity. Then there is limited liability of owners. The obligation or debts of the company does not create a change over the owner's personal assets. The liability is limited only for the subscribed capital unpaid by them. Then you get taxation benefits. One person company is not recognized under the Income Tax Act and hence it has been put in the same category as other companies for taxation purposes. Private companies have been placed under the tax bracket of 30% on total income. Thus, from a perspective of taxation, the concept of one person company becomes a less profitable concept as it imposes a heavy financial load on the owner of the one person company. Then you will have a separate legal existence as you had in one person company. A private limited company registered a legal entity is born in the eyes of law which is separate from its owners and managers. The private company can operate in its own name from opening a bank account to own assets and enter into a contract with party. This also provides the capacity to sue third party. Now what are the documents that are required to convert your OPC to a private limited company? First is PAN card of shareholders and directors. Foreign nationals must provide a passport. Second is identity proof. Voter ID, passport, driving license, shareholders and directors is required. Then you must have address proof that is you could be your telephone bill, electricity bill, latest bank account statement of shareholders and directors. Then photograph, latest passport size, photographs of shareholders and directors must be attached on the application. In case of anyone is NRI or foreign national, documents of partner must be notarized or apostilled. Then financial statement, duly certified copy of latest audited financial statement must be attached. Incorporation documents of the OPC, certification of incorporation, MOA and AOA to be provided. So these are the documents that are required if you want to convert your OPC to a private limited company. And with this, I would like to end my video and I hope you like this video. Thank you for watching.